that he's mounting himself on wings as a parrot. Why am I not telling you that you should become like a parrot? Why are we focusing on you becoming an eagle? Just look at it, the eagle versus the parrot. Parrots never have original ideas of their own. So I'm glad God did not say they shall mount on wings like parrots. He said we shall mount on wings like eagles. Why? Because parrots never have any original ideas of their own. Parrots only report what others have done, but do nothing of their own. Have you ever thought of that? All parrots say stay in their cage. They mimic what everybody else is saying, but they don't have original ideas of their own. So a parrot Christian doesn't have any personal testimonies. Parrots only accuse other people. Parrots are village storytellers. Same way, parrot Christians are too busy accusing other Christians. They just copy the ideas of other people. They do not ask God for their own divine revelation. Parrot Christians are storytellers. They can keep secrets, just like the parrot, the bird. But eagle flies on his own agenda. The eagle flies on his own revelation. He doesn't do copy. You have not been born to do a copy. You cannot transform your environment. If all you do is copy it, the eagle runs his own race. The eagle fly on his own assignment. The eagle is too busy pursuing his own flight to copy others. I don't know that any eagle believers listen to me right now. If you believe you're an eagle believer or you want to be one now, you better start typing eagle on that screen right now. Better start claiming it. You don't want to operate with the spirit of parrot. You want to operate with the spirit of an eagle so that you can have your own unique revelation, so that you don't just keep regurgitating stuff that people have dumped into your life. You will discover your own assignment when you have the eagle spirit. See, there are so many parrots in Christendom that's ridiculous. Some of us, even at the level of pastors, we preach and we quote verses that we have never thought about on our own. We are only preaching the religion of other people that taught us. I was like that my first few months as a pastor, because I was a very young person. I didn't know much about the Bible myself. All I did was go, and I've said it several times, my first 3 or 6 months as a pastor, I preached mostly the sermons of Pastor Tunde Bakary, because that's the first person I was introduced to. When I listened to his sermon, I was just blown away. Oh, this guy knows it. And then I ordered all his sermon tapes, and I would listen to it, and then I would make notes, and then I'll go and download. And I was doing great. God was glorifying himself, regardless of the fact that I was operating with his parrot spirit, because I never really sat down and started thinking about some of the stuff he's saying. He's a man. Yes, he's very much intelligent. But he read the same Bible. It took me a while to start doing that. Then I realized that I have a different take sometimes on the Bible, and that's okay. I'm flowing in my own anointing. And that is my wish for you today. You will not operate as a parrot Christian. Some of you want to preach, what you talk about, is what your overseer said, is what your senior pastor said, is what your senior, your pastor over you said. You have not thought about it. And sometimes your pastors, they don't know it all. Sometimes the circumstance they even gave you is different from what you are quoting right now. And then you tell yourself, because he said it, it must be right. No, it doesn't have to be right. You as an eagle, you have to operate on your own agenda. As a Christian, you get your own divine revelation of where to be. I told you, I wanted to be like a battery. I wanted to be like, even there was a time I also shifted. I wanted to be like one of my friends who's a prayer warrior pastor. The man is really gifted with the ability to pray for deliverance and all that. And I envied that spirit. I wanted it. So I started trying to preach like him. That's the parrot spirit, but I'm not him. And the spirit realm can feel you, guys. If you are operating with the parrot spirit, they know. They know that's not the real you. There's a reason why you are shaped differently from any other human being. There's a reason why the fingers of your hands are never the same. That's a reason why your fingerprints are never the same with any other person. That's a reason why your ears, many of you do not know that, the ears are never exactly the same. That is why in U.S. immigration, they take pictures of your ear as part of your fingerprint. Why do you think God did that if all he wanted was for you to come to this world and come and be copying somebody else? It is okay when you are just starting. You don't know your left from your right. So it's not like I regret what I did my first 6 months. I didn't know better. But as I began to figure it out, it occurred to me that I got to find my own voice. I have to find my own ministry. People don't have to agree with me. A lot of stuff that I'm going to be preaching, a lot of stuff I've been preaching, a lot of people don't agree with me, and I'm cool with that. But at least now, I can confidently tell myself I'm flowing in my own anointing. My revelations are original. It's fine if it tallies with some word somebody else is saying, because God's Spirit is one. So obviously, there are many people that God has put in His kingdom to preach different things. So I will find some kindred that resonate with my type of preaching. But when I wake up now, I think for myself, Christians, Eagle Christians, operate like that. You will have your own unique revelation in the mighty name of Jesus. You have been in the ministry for a long time, but you don't even know why you are in ministry, because you don't have your own personal revelation for ministry. All you do is copy your pastor. All you do is copy your leader. And I don't have a problem with that. Some of the pastors I'm building up myself now, I expect that the first few months or even maybe 1 year, they are still learning from me. So because they don't know, they are probably still repeating some of the stuff that I teach them without having dealt with. But I teach them. As I said, you need to think about it. Let God give you a revelation about it too, so that when you are preaching it, you are a believer, not just regurgitating what the pastor said. You have thought about it, and the Holy Spirit has confirmed to you that this is the truth. That's what Eagle Christians do. They are critical. They're Liberian Christians. They listen, but they cite their spirit. They cite the scripture, and they get their own voice. Some of us, our voices is not where they are right now. You are trying to be somebody else. You have a different anointing. But because you covet the anointing of somebody else, you operate the same way in business. Many of us go into businesses because somebody says it's a good business. We have not done our own shape analysis to see whether that even suits us. The parrot Christian only talks the talk of the kingdom citizen, but does not walk the walk. The parrot believer only quotes what the word says without living the word. Every time we quote and we don't live it, we are basically operating with the parrot anointing or the parrot spirit. And we all need to be delivering ourselves, because we all operate at it at different levels. The parrot Christian only mimics other people's mistakes and accuses others without convicting himself first. They like to point fingers. That's a parrot spirit. Today, God is looking for the Eagle citizens, because He needs transformation of this world. That's why He put us here. God did not put us here to come to heaven. Again, like I said, I like to be controversial with that. I'm going to take a pause and do a little detour on that. I love to talk about that. No, look at me. I'm looking at it straight in the street. God did not put you on this earth for you to come to heaven. Adam was not created in heaven. Adam was created here. Adam was not commissioned in heaven. Adam was commissioned here. Adam was not given a mission field in heaven. He was given a mission field here. That was when everything was perfect. And when he fell, he lost that commission. But the commission in love was on the earth. So why are we so much in a hurry to go to heaven? I say this all the time. I even have a whole full sermon on that. Why are Christians so much in a hurry to go to heaven? They're the only ambassadors I know. Their only desire is to go to headquarters. It's ridiculous. If you have been put on earth to be an ambassador of Christ in heaven, shouldn't your major focus should be how you be the best ambassador you can on this earth? So that when you die, you can then be welcomed into the headquarters for having done a job. Every society I know, they have a plan to control the systems of this world, except the church. Our own strategy is to escape the world. Meanwhile, we have been set to go and control the systems. When it says control, so the mandate we were given in the garden was to control the systems that run this earth, not even as the physical, the systems, the laws, the morals, the culture, the resources that control what happened on the earth. That is what we have been told to go and dominate. On here, we are ambassadors of Christ. Our work is done on earth. Nobody's going to work in heaven. But yet, most of the time, all we want to talk is, hey, I'm going to make heaven, I'm going to make heaven, as if that is your number one assignment. That's not your number one assignment. I don't care what anybody tells, go read the scripture. If you didn't lose your inheritance in heaven, if you are not walking in heaven, you didn't lose your house in heaven. Now to get it back, you are looking to heaven to go get it. It makes no sense. It's like somebody who owns a house in Lagos. And then they put him there to run the house as an agent. Then he messed up. Then the landlord drives him out of that house that is in Lagos. Now that person that has been driven out is trying to get back his mandate. Will he now go to Sri Lanka to go look for the house that he wants to manage? is another house in Lagos we'll be trying to get back to. We lost our mandate in the Garden of Eden. That is where we are being restored to. That is where we should go do our work. And the Garden of Eden now, after Jesus, it is you getting your own spiritual environment to push the kingdom agenda. So the Garden of Eden is now a spiritual place. When you reconcile with God, now you get your own Eden. Whether you're an internet marketer, whether you're a lawyer, whether you're a doctor, whether you're a housewife, whether you're whatever it is you are, that is now your immediate environment. It's now your Eden to operate. And when you die, obviously, like I said, heaven is your headquarters. Heaven is our home. Heaven is our citizenship. But no ambassador goes to work every morning, and all his plan is how will he get back to America if an ambassador of America to Nigeria. Don't think it would be funny if you wake up in the morning. All you are concerned about is how you make it back to America. How do you think Mr. President Trump will rate you? Your job when you wake up as an ambassador is, how can I make my place if you are operating in Nigeria? How can I make Nigeria look like U.S.? If you're an ambassador of U.S. to Togo, when you wake up in Nigeria, all your activities is, how will I make Togo to look like America? Because when you die, according to 1 Corinthians 3:10-17, you will be judged by the king who sent you based on how well you operated in the kingdom territory. I cannot overemphasize this. Dr. Miles Monroe spent 35 years of his life preaching this one message. I'm not saying we're not going to go. I'm not saying there is no heaven. I'm saying that heaven is not your number one assignment. That's not why you are put here. God will be a very funny God if all he did was he put you on this earth and all he's waiting is to see whether you're going to reconcile yourself to him. That's his number one desire. And all his desire, rather. Okay, whether this boy will give his life. No. God can't. That makes no sense. Of course, the primary thing you want to reconcile yourself to your maker. Don't get me wrong. I'm not levitating or reducing the value of giving your life to Christ. That is the beginning point. That is what God wants first. But after you do that, the primary thing God wants you to do then is to transform this environment. You don't want to be a parrot Christian who has not gotten his own revelation. God is looking for those who will not only talk the talk of victory, but will live the life of victory on this earth. Not those who are saying, I fly away, oh glory. No. Before you fly away in glory, you take territories. The time has come for the eagle Christian to rise. And I'm believing God with you today. You will rise to your calling. You will rise to your vision. You will rise above gossip. You will rise above storytelling. You will overcome. And you will live in victory in the mighty name of Jesus. They that wait upon the Lord shall mount on wings of eagles, not on wings of parrots. There is just too many parroty things going on in Christendom. All we do is repeat bad news. All we do is repeat what somebody has done or not done. We are not flying, but I believe in God for you. That this is it. This next few weeks, as we begin to unpack it, the Lord himself will begin to show himself powerfully in your life because you have been called.